Hi guys, at the end of the last vid you saw me putting down some Citadel shades on the jet bike. After they've all dried up, what I try and tend to do is re-highlight all the areas which are a little too dark, and also where the light would catch. So I go over the entire model again with Vallejo Model Air Steel, reshading back in the lighter areas of the model, and some of the areas you'll see me using the side of the brush so that the paint goes straight to where I need it to, without having to use the tip all the time. That's usually quite a good way of doing things here. I have to do a little bit of brass at the front as well, so it just cleans it all up. What I'm now doing is putting down a gloss varnish. This is mainly for the decals that I put on the jet bike, and also to give it a general protection whilst I'm handling it and messing around with it. Now putting on some Vallejo decal fixer. This is where I've already pre-decided where I'm going to be putting some of my decals. And then I put it down and let it dry for about 15 minutes. Then I get the transfers out, give them a good soak in warm water, and they should glide off. Use a fair bit of water on the surface before you actually put them on. It gives you the ability to move them around a little bit if you need to. I always dab them, let them dry, give them a good 15-20 minutes before you start doing this next stage. Very gently with a knife, guys, very gently, because you can go straight through the layers of the paint. You don't want to do this. I only brought my airbrush in there to blow away all the dust and debris. Yet again I'm using my mix of washes, as it were, just on top of the decals, just to take away the shine of the white, so that doesn't shine through too much, especially with the colour of the rest of the jet bike. Now using decal medium, which softens the whole edge of a decal and gets rid of that kind of shiny bit that goes around all the white or all the print of the decal once that's set. Here I'm just doing the monitor on the inside of the bike, do a nice blue and mix the blue with some light sea blue and create a nice little effect. And then the dial at the top, similar effect but using with fire red and a light orange, or light red, sorry, mixed in. And then once you've got all those in, go in with a dot of white, show a kind of reflective. I could go into more detail on these things, but I just wanted to show tabletop standard here, guys, not go too far. What I now do is go over the entire bike with Model Air Gun. This is where all the chipping effects will be, and we'll be going back inside all of those areas. So make it as random as you want. Sometimes, and I'll admit it, I use it to cover up mistakes or errors, but chipping effects do look nice like that. And go again with the steel, but inside the gun, leaving a little bit of the gun colour underneath, so it looks like it's more worn and less worn in different areas. I think it gives a nice effect. And so, just a quick little tip, the aquila at the front, which is gold, I did a little bit of steel just to show like chips of the gold flakes flaking off. And then I hit the whole jet bike with a matte varnish, and the bike itself is done now. We've just got to go onto the man and the guns. So, hope you like it.